All right, guys, just a quick video on how I deploy my VMs. I use minimal Ubuntu cloud images and CloudInit. The first thing is Google Ubuntu minimal images. You can do the same for other distros as well. So if I click on Ubuntu minimal cloud images, these are all the images available. This is for 22.10, and then we also have for 22.04. 22.04 has the longest support, whereas 22.10 only has few months support. How do I know? I looked at the Kinetic Kudos release notes, and that is just supported for 9 months, and saying if you need long-term support, use this one. So I'm gonna be using that one. Click that. And I am going to pick up the latest, which I believe is in here. And then I'm looking for this amd64.img file. So I'm gonna right click, copy link, and I am going to open up a shell. I'm in root. I'm just going to wget it here. So while it's going, we can create a VM. I am going to call this 200, and that's my Ubuntu 22.04 minimal template. We click next. We're not going to use any media. Click next. I'm gonna tick this chemo agent. Click next. We are not going to attach any hard drive just now, so delete that. Click next. As default, one socket, 8 cores is enough. 10 to enable NUMA, and if I need to add anything else, we can do that later, but for a template, it's more than enough. And click next. Default is fine. Click next. I'm gonna use my pfSense LAN for all VMs. Untick that. Click next, and click finish. So this will go and create a VM. It's already done that. Now if I come in hardware, cloud init, there's no drive, so let's add a cloud init drive, and I am going to put it on supersonic, and it's gonna be a SCSI. Click add. So here is my cloud init drive. So now if I go in there, I can edit these. And if you have a public SSH key, you can put that in here. Let's click OK. And you can set your network. I use DHCP. IPv6, I don't use that for now. So we can just click OK. And we can regenerate our image. So that's all sorted. Now open up a shell to Proxmox, and we should see our Ubuntu image, but first we are going to run this command. So qm set the ID is 200, serial 0, socket VGA serial 0. If you're not gonna run this command, you will not be able to see any output on the console when you create your VMs. So you need to run that. Make sure you also match the ID to whatever ID you set up for your template. So enter that. The next thing is we are going to resize our image file to a default of 32 gigs. So that's resized. And now we are ready to attach this image to our template. So we can do that using qm import disk to 200. That's our Ubuntu image, and then you need to specify which storage. So I'm gonna say super sonic because that's my enterprise NVMe. So enter, and now it is importing the disk into my VM. So that is successfully imported. So if I now go back in their hardware, that's our unused disk. We can edit this, discard, because this is NVMe, I'm going to turn on SSID's emulation as well. And that is a SCSI disk. Fine. I think everything else is fine. So I'm going to add this disk. And now it has been added. Now that the disk is sorted, we need to make sure it appears in the boot order. So options, boot order, edit. And there it is. So you need to enable it, and you can put it after your CD-ROM, just in case you want to use CD-ROM in the future. And click OK. Boot at start, I'll leave to no for now, and I can change it on a VM basis. Order, I can change it on a VM basis. So I think that's all we had to set up. I think we are ready to convert it into a template now. So right click there and convert to template. But make sure you've set up all these settings. Once you convert it to template, you cannot change anything else. And you will have to destroy this and redo it all over again. So let's convert to template. Yes. So you should see icon being changed soon. There it is. That's been converted to template. Now, if I want to deploy any VMs, I can right click and clone it. I like to do full clone. I tend to change my VM IDs to match the template IDs. So I will call it 201. Name Oasis. This is the server I'm gonna be setting up my Plex and other media management software using Docker and Portainer. So that's the video coming up next. Target storage, the same. Resource pool, the same. So everything else is fine. So let's clone it. It's almost there. So that's deployed. Let's look at there, hardware. I want to extend my hard disk from 32 GB to minimum of 80 GB. So I need to add another, let's say 48 GB to it. Click resize. Now it's 80 GB. I'm going to assign more processors as well. So edit that. And I am going to assign 16 threads. This will be host and nothing here. So okay. And I am also going to increase memory to minimum of 12 gigs, or actually I'm gonna assign it 16 gigs. So for that, we're gonna enter this and okay. So that's 16 gigs. I set up host here because I'm gonna pass through one of my GPUs for Plex transcoding. So that's why I had to change it to host. Everything else is fine. So let's go to console and hit start. So it's created the SSH keys as well for the VM. And if I hit enter, yep, the login prompt here. And now we should set up our pfSense DHCP leases. And I want to change it to, so host name, it is showing as Ubuntu. And if I do IPA, that's the IP address it's been assigned to it. So I'm going to assign a static IP from pfSense. So let's go there. And this was it. So I'm gonna click plus, and I am going to set up it to be Oasis IP address, let's say 10.10, host name, I'm gonna call it Oasis, DNS servers, that's my pi hole, and this address, nothing else here. Click save, hit apply. And now if I go back there, if I do sudo apt update. So the good thing about cloud init images is they're all up to date, nothing to change. So if I do sudo apt install chemo guest agent, it will install the chemo agent. And let's reboot to get my new IP address. So I'm back. Let's log in. IPA, and that's 1010. And if I go to summary, I can see the IPs here as well. So that's how you can assign static IPs in pfSense to your newly deployed cloud init images. Hope you liked it, and you can clone as many as you want with literally no effort.